This film is intended for eye surgeons for training and education purposes. Viewer discretion is strongly recommended. Hi, this is Dr. Deepak Megur, and just let's have a look at one of my old cases and try to learn something here. This is an elderly male patient who is having phacoelastic glaucoma with an hypermature Morganian cataract, and with, you can see these calcific spots on the anterior capsule, all suggestive of a very long-standing cataract, and I expect a very weak capsular bag as well as zonules in this patient. The case is being performed under peribulbar anesthesia, and I have created the scleral tunnel and I'm entering the eye by making these two side port entries. The capsule is stained, OVD is injected into the eye to pressurize it. The scleral tunnel entry is done, and now is the time to perform the capsulotomy. So as expected, once I puncture, there is an egress of liquid cortex out here. So to improve visualization, I'm doing gentle irrigation to ensure that the fluid comes out, and suddenly I can see that the inferior bag just folds up, suggesting that there is a localized area of zonular weakness, and probably vitreous would be trying to come out there. So I block that area by using dispersive OVD, which acts like a tamponade and barrier, and I'm now continuing with my rexus. So the plan is to perform initial small rexus, but as I hit these calcific areas, again, it becomes a little bit difficult for me to tear, but nonetheless, I could get hold of a very small rexus. Well, this was the most critical step of the surgery because this gives me an opportunity to place the CTR inside now itself. By putting the CTR inside, it's going to stabilize the bag. Before I do that, again, I fill the bag and inflate it with a cohesive OVD. I'm using sodium hyaluronate that will create space within the bag and push it across. And when I'm trying to insert the ring, it will not cause any stress on the loose bag. So that's the idea of using that viscoelastic. So viscoelastic is holding the bag in place until the CTR is being threaded into it. So once the CTR gets into the bag, now is the time to enlarge the rexus. The challenge is to deal with the part where we have calcification. So I'm making a cut in the opposite quadrant, and then I'm trying to negotiate a rexus by avoiding those specks of calcification. But unfortunately, I hit a roadblock here, wherein as I try to tear the capsule, the bag in that quadrant is threatening to come out. So I stop there, and I have a different technique here. I use a vitrector to cut that area of the capsule which has got extremely loose zonules. The benefit of using a vitrector is that it cuts it, the capsule, without causing any traction. We can as well use a scissors, but this is my preferred technique. Once the problematic area with the weak zonules is taken care of, the rest of the capsule is dealt in a conventional fashion using scissors and a forceps. Once we have a decent sized opening in the capsule, the nucleus is gently maneuvered out of the bag and removed out of the eye. Gentle irrigation is being done to flush out any remaining cortex. There's hardly any. The bag is now being filled with sodium hyaluronate so that the space is created inside the bag. And then I'm planning to implant the multi-piece lens into the bag. Whenever we have a zonular dehiscence, there is a higher risk of the fluid percolating across it and getting accumulated in the Berger space and then causing positive pressure. So that is something like a misdirection syndrome. So the misdirection syndrome is the one of the most common reasons why we have positive pressures, especially in such eyes with compromised zonules. So having a good viscoelastic helps here. Once the lens is in place, I'm putting in triamcinolone acetate to rule out any presence of vitreous which could have migrated across the weak zonules. Seems to be just a little bit there. I'm just doing some anterior vitrectomy. We can clearly see that the triamcinolone acetate has migrated across the zonules into the Burgers space. It'll remain there, no problem at all. Final one time, I'm going to recheck for presence of any prolapse vitreous. There is none. Time to close. The conjunctiva is covered back and I'm using a buried knot of 8-0 acryl to cover the scleral incision, and that's it, the case was done. To summarize, in this case, the key take-home message was, so whenever we're dealing with an eye with a localized or generalized weakness, I think inserting a CTR early enough is going to help us in salvaging the bag. In this situation, doing a RECSIS itself was challenging because of the presence of those calcified spots. So what I did was, I initially did a very small RECSIS, which would help me to put in a ring, and the ring is going to go and stabilize the bag. And then I'm going to enlarge the capsular opening, which will facilitate the nucleus delivery, and then everything becomes routine. So that was it in this case. Thank you for watching and hope this helps.